For more than a decade, a group of Korean scientists have been closely studying changes to the polar climate. They returned from an expedition to the Arctic on South Korea's icebreaker ship, the Araon. Choi Min-jung went on board to file this report.
Just a few weeks ago, a team of South Korean experts returned from an 85-day trip to the North Pole. I'm here at the Korea Polar Research Institute to meet the researchers in Songdo.
The Korea Polar Research Institute, or KOPRI for short, has been researching the changes in the Arctic Ocean for 12 years. During their latest trip, researchers carried out simultaneous ozone observations at both poles using helium balloons.
Everyone knows that there is an ozone hole over Antarctica, but even in the Arctic, ozone levels are gradually decreasing. That's why it's important to monitor ozone concentrations in the Arctic as well.
KOPRI says its advances in polar research have been accelerated by the introduction of South Korea's first and only icebreaker ship, the Araon. It's specially designed to navigate across icy waters, allowing it to sail through areas where ordinary ships can't, including the polar regions. The Araon rises above the ice sheet to break the ice using its own weight. Two propellers at the back push the broken pieces of ice away to prevent them from freezing again near the vessel. If the Araon gets stuck in the middle of an ice sheet, the ice healing system shakes the vessel to the left and right to help it escape. And unlike how most ships are shaped in the front, it has a sharper, sloping bow and an ice knife underneath. It's also structurally stronger with outer walls 3 times thicker than ordinary ships. Inside the Araon, there are 10 research labs. Scientists send research equipment into the sea and collect samples to bring to the labs for analysis.
This is where the researchers sleep and rest. There's a bed, a TV, and a shower room. Enough to keep them comfy for the trip.
Another key spot of the Araon is the helipad. Because it can carry its own helicopter, many experts have found this very useful.
Helicopter access from the Araon is key to what they're going to attempt to do because the area is quite dangerous, frankly, and you need to be able to land on a spot that's safe.
The contributions made by KOPRI are being acknowledged globally, despite it being a relatively late starter to polar research.
I think the icebreaker, to a large extent, is important in terms of making KOPRI more relevant. And if we look at other big international collaborations, KOPRI is now in all of them.
South Korea's researchers are currently busy as they are gearing up for their next journey, this time heading south.
The Araon will take off to Antarctica next week, where experts on board will spend the next 6 months observing how climate change is affecting the polar region. Choi Min-jung, Arirang News, Yeosu.